We will start the construction of the piers by placing helping lines on a separate level, so this level can be hidden when we place our pier. We start with two different lines, one which will be vertical and the other one will be horizontal. Then we place a construction line that indicates the slope of the cap. Then we will add some more construction lines indicating where we place the top and the bottom of both columns. Two vertical lines at the top that indicate the two intersection points of the columns, and joining these two elements with an horizontal line. And we do the same for the bottom of the column by placing the same two vertical lines and an horizontal line, indicating through this intersection point where we will place the column. Then finally, we will place the line indicating the center of the columns by joining these intersection points. Here we have the construction line that will help us to place the different elements. We can change level then and place the first element of our pier, first defining the cap with a rectangle, then placing another rectangle that will define the base of our pier. We have all the elements now for the construction, and we will be able to start with constraints. Let's go to the constraints tab inside Micro Session or OpenBridge Modeler, and first we fix the first vertical element, so to be sure that everything is coordinated with that. Then we fix our horizontal element, starting with the same original point, and finally a slope element also with the same origin at the bottom point of our vertical line. Now we can place some other constraint. We will indicate that all three lines are coming to the same point, the horizontal, the vertical, and the sloped one, on both sides of the columns. Do the same at the bottom. So all these construction lines are perfectly constrained to the horizontal elements and to the vertical elements. Now we can add more constraints in terms of parallelism. First, we will define that the side of the cap are vertical, whatever happens to the slope of the cap. So that means that both sides will be parallel to the vertical line. We do the same for the small side of the base that will be also vertical. Let's continue with some direction of the different elements. So we will indicate that these small construction lines are also vertical for the top and for the bottom of the column. Finally, we indicate that both sides of the cap are parallel, that this construction line will remain parallel also to the top of the slab. Then finally, that are based will be horizontal, so parallel to our horizontal line. Here we see a list of variables that we have prepared. And the first assignment we will do is an angle from the slope to the vertical that will be used to take into account the super elevation of the bridge on the cap. We indicate that a fixed point on the cap is the middle of the cap, here. And we will set up our cap as parallel to the slope. Everything is turning, so both sides of the cap and the construction line. Now, let's indicate that cap is symmetrical, so both sides are at the same distance from the center of the pier. The same for the base. We have the same distance from both sides, and you see that automatically the element is readjusted. Now, we indicate the same for the construction of our columns, so the top of the column, theoretical top of the column, will be also at the same distance from the center line. And the same for the bottom column, bottom points of the column, which will be symmetrical on the pier. We can now assign some variables to some distance, so the length of the cap, for example, so which we assign, and you see that automatically it is extended to the value. We do the same for the base. Something gets wrong because we didn't fix this to be perpendicular. Okay, so first we fix that this is perpendicular, and as the side of the base are vertical, the top and the bottom of the base will remain also horizontal. So now we can reassign the length of the base and we see that it takes its place. We want that the construction line be in the center of our base, so let's redefine that both lines are at the same distance from our construction line. And finally, we can define the depth of the base by assigning the value. We can define now the distance between the two construction points. We define that the cap is also symmetrical, and mainly we place this construction line in the middle of our cap by assigning equal value of distance. Then we can define the size of the cap by assigning the dimension here. Let's continue with assigning the distance. We define that the height of the pier, so put it around the drawing, which is from our origin to the bottom part of or slab, and we assign the height of the pier, which is automatically adjusted. So, for the small construction element not to disappear, we assign the same length to that four elements. It's just a question to see them clearly. Check that everything is okay by changing some parameters. So changing the length of the base, changing the thickness of the base. Now we define the distance between the two theoretical points of intersection of the column by assigning a variable, delta between bottom of column, and we do the same for the top distance. Something gets wrong. So when something gets wrong, just undo. Control Z. We will take again the distance of this element. So we assign the distance, horizontal distance between, no, true distance, excuse me, between this element, and assigning a variable. And now it's correct. Let's move again, modify again some variables. So everything is okay. Change the distance between the theoretical points, and they are also okay. Change the bottom. Still okay. So everything is constrained properly, so now we can go on modeling. And we will place our first solid. First, we will define the cap and the base. So, by extrusion, we take the distance, the half width of the cap, and check that we create a volume, so half width, excuse me, of the base, and we create the volume. We change our distance to the half width of the cap and create in the same way the volume at the top. Now we have both our top and our base. We will draw the column. For that we draw also along the line, so with an inner diameter of 0 and outer diameter equal to the column radius. Be careful to show construction element because we will need them for constraint. So we place the column, first column, place the second column. You see that the clone takes the same level as the path, so that means they are placed on construction, so we will move them to our peer level by selecting them and adjust the level. Now we will finish the construction of our solid by creating an union solid with these four elements. So starting with the cap, adding each column by pressing Ctrl at the same time, and we accept, and automatically we have the final elements. So now we need to place more constraints on. We have constrained the path, but we need to constrain also the circular element. For that, first we will define that our circle will remain perpendicular to the axis of the column. So we show first the line, then we show the circle, which will remain perpendicular to the path. At the same time, we see that we have coincident point between the top of the construction element and the center of the circle. We do the same on the other side, where select the line, this shows line, okay, then select the circle, its plane will be perpendicular also to the construction element, which is the center of the cylinder. And at the same time we say that, so the center of the circle is coincident with that point. So now we have finished our element, and let's check that it's okay. If we change the peer height, so everything is following. If we change the space between the column, also we see that the columns are adjusted. Everything seems okay with our model. We are working a DGN, so what we will do, we will copy this DGN into a cell file. So just rename it as sample_peer.cell, and we enter again this file, which is our cell file. We will check two things in this cell file. We will check that our model can be placed as a cell and is considered as a parametric cell. Here is a cell. We save settings so we can see it like that when we code the cell. And we go to the model. You see this model can be called as a cell, but if we look at properties, we can see that cell can be placed as cell, and this cell is parametric. Everything is correct, so we can exit this file. Finally, we will enter the same cell file within OpenBridge Modeler. In the OpenBridge Modeler, you see at the end parametric cell. So the first is to assign different materials. As we have made an union, you see we have only one element. So we can only assign one type of material. If we want to separate, we have to divide in different elements. But here we can say that the length of the cap will be assigned to cap lengths. L cap will be assigned to the cap length, and the angle will be assigned to cap slope angle. So now we can test up here in an open bridge model. So let's go to an open bridge model. We will copy our cell file to the functional components directory. You see we have all these functional elements inside, and be sure that in the definition of the microstation variables, so in the configuration variables, if we go to configuration variables, if you select OBM, okay, so be sure then in the OBM peer cell list, by default is assigned to peer cell lib.cell, you have star.cell of all the functional components. Now we display the bridge and we have a dynamic cross section on the right along the peer. We call a peer here, select the line, and we assign that the width will be equal to the deck. So you see that our cap has been reduced to the width of the deck and the element is placed. If we want to change some parameters, just select the element here with a fence, you see that we have our parametric cell and all the different variables here. So we can change the variable. I put radius of colon, in fact it's diameter. So let's change it anyway, 1 meter, you see it's updated. We can change also, for example, the height of the pier, because today it's not automatically set to the level of the ground, but it will be in next release. So we can adjust it manually. And we can change like that all the different parameters. But remember that we have assigned the slope of the cap to the super elevation of our bridge. So if we change the super elevation of the bridge, now let's redefine the slope of our bridge. So we go to the intrinsic variable rotation by angle. For example, we put a 5-degree slope from the beginning to the end of a bridge, and we can see that automatically we will see that the cap automatically adjusts to the same slope of a bridge.